Hey, it's Soul, and I've been spending a lot of time, probably too much time, talking about Torments, the controversial addition to Torghast that many fans are concerned about, and many others have immediately demanded that it just be thrown out. I can't help but find it, like, a little bit amusing that as gamers we're used to solving problems with creative use of whatever it is that we have available, but also as gamers, in a game that is still in its alpha stages, you know, Shadowlands alpha, we'd rather eliminate every single obstacle in our way while we still can. But that's like the first of several times I'm gonna veer off in today's discussion. Well, today's video is a discussion of Torments, including feedback, suggestions, and maybe a little bit of bitching. I'm coming from a position not of expertise and know-how, but plenty of passion and a lot of playtesting. As a fan, I want to make Torghast work, with or without Torments, and also to understand Blizzard's intentions, maybe think up some other ideas to fit their philosophies while delivering on their original so-called promises. I think I'm onto something that everyone can be fairly happy with in such a way that it doesn't blow minds or simply let Blizzard roll over under pressure, but the aim is today to get people to be like, oh, okay, well, yeah, that's not so bad. Sure. Let's start with what we're working with currently, which are Torments, and what they aim to do. The term thrown around by critics is timer. Timer, timer, timer. It's like the new derogatory word, flavor of the month sort of thing. Blizz, we don't want timers. Timers are Mythic Plus, Horrific Visions, Island Expeditions 2.0. And no matter how soft Torments are, it's the feeling of having this said timer that makes us feel uncomfortable. So Blizz, don't make a mechanic designed to curb a tiny subset of behavior that ends up affecting almost everyone negatively. And that's a good-ass argument. It's personal, and you can't deny it. Looking a little bit deeper, it's not a timer, really, that's the problem. Mostly because Torments, opinion time, Torments aren't a timer at all, per se. And Torments are like a mechanic that can easily be overcome through good decision-making with anima powers and, of course, good gameplay. What's 1000% more magic damage if you can avoid all spell damage? Or if you're on a floor where almost no magic damage is being dealt anyway? How much time do you have left when the time doesn't matter? But here we are, you know, we're getting stuck again, so don't respond to that, stop typing. At least for now, there's a lot more to discuss and for you to rail on me about. I'm going to share my feedback and look at each of the Torments in the current alpha. I'm going to give my take on each one based on not theory crafting, but good old testing, my experiences. And for what it's worth, the highest floor that I climbed in the alpha, at least in this testing period, is floor 30 as a Beastmaster Hunter. Yeah, I know, pet classes. You know how powerless I am not having a paladin in Torghast, so please just give me a break on that one. And for the sake of argument, I'm going to reveal that across all of the classes that I've tested in Torghast so far, that an average sized floor will take roughly 10 or so minutes to kill every mob inside before I go back, you know, backtrack to open chests, complete puzzles, and so on and so forth, and this is without me leaving my keyboard. So first, let's go over the gear check torments. The Might of the Upper Reaches increases physical damage vulnerability by 1% every 60 seconds, and it stacks up to 5% every 60 seconds after climbing 5 floors. Mortrigar's Echoes does the same thing, except it's magic damage. These torments can be super, super annoying, especially when starting on higher floors, when you only have your class abilities to keep you going, and at this stage of the alpha, neither soul binds nor gear upgrades come into play. If you're struggling to kill things right away and the torment is making it that much worse, well, this is the game pretty much telling you to either go down a few ranks or a few floors, or to get some gear at item level and come back. Otherwise, to counter these torments, it was very helpful for me to use anima powers that let me cut mobs, or to slow spell casting, or even prevent spell casts from going off on me outside of a certain range. Once I got a few choice powers and hit a stride though on my classes, I was just ripping through enemies way faster than the debuff would stack, even after 5 stacks, even with AFKs and everything else. Believe me, really, it's not the best simulation, but during a certain run, I RP walked through some higher floors, and I still fully cleared it just so I can tell you that I RP walked and cleared a bunch of floors. I don't recommend doing that sort of testing. Okay, next, Soulforge is a unique torment that inflicts 1% of your maximum health as damage every 5 seconds, and it stacks up to 5. This one I found to be a little bit fun because countering it was, transactional, or it felt fulfilling. Countering this is fairly simple for self-healing classes and specs, otherwise your best bet is to obtain anima powers that provide some self-healing and damage reduction, and there are quite a few of them. Imagine being a warrior who constantly has Ignore Pain on, and Exhilaration for Hunters that has almost no cooldown, or Blink will like heal you and it has no cooldown. There are a lot of general anima powers as well that steal health while inflicting some ridiculous damage. This of course is counterbalanced when you pick up one too many anima powers that increase your maximum HP, something that you do want to do. But because of that, because then you're losing that much more life and you may need to once again compensate with more life restoration anima powers. The problem with Soulforge comes during those inevitable moments when, the cat's on fire, the baby's crying, you need to step away, and your anima powers or abilities just aren't passive enough. If you're in a group, this probably won't be as big of a deal, but for solo play, it puts you in that mindset that breaks should be limited to between floors when you're in a rest area. In that sense, you've got to pre-plan your next move. It's not a big deal, but there are always those quick AFK emergencies that come up, and no one wants that to lead to a bad gameplay experience, although it does happen. Next are the ad-spawning torments, the Eye of Scoldus, and the Fracturing Forces. In so few words, while out of combat, you periodically get ambushed by these mobs at set intervals, which is a little bit deceptive. So here's what I got from testing. If you have Fracturing Forces on, for example, and you've been out of combat for exactly 28 seconds before fighting a pack, after leaving combat, in 2 seconds, Fracturing Forces will proc and they're on ya. And that's so freaking annoying. At higher levels though, even when combined with the damage vulnerability torment or whatnot, these mobs are trivial once you get to a sufficient anima power level, so these guys are just super obnoxious. Their greatest threat to you is if you're going to be AFK for a really long time, or if you're just trying to get a food buff. Finally, there's the Breath of Cold Heart, which reduces the damage that you do by 1 to 5% every 2 minutes. Take this out, straight up, just make it go away. This is a torment that punishes your ability to kill quickly by making it even harder for you to kill things, right? It's the kind of torment that you can overgear, which isn't a thing in the alpha at the moment, but if I was in the mood to challenge myself, like if I wanted to push floors and I know that I'm going to struggle, and I happen to see this torment on the first floor that I'm climbing, that's it, dude, I'm done. I just wasted my key or whatever it is, because I know it's going to take upwards of like 20 to 30 minutes just to complete one of these floors. And ultimately, this torment is just too much to bear. I've spoken with a handful of alpha testers who have also had mixed feelings about Torments. I'm not going to bore you with the back and forth, but here were my takeaways from it. Torments are most punishing before you get sufficient anima powers. Once you do get enough anima powers, torments don't even matter, regardless of how much time you spend exploring or AFKing. Torments encourage taking the path of least resistance, meaning player behavior is going to be to start at low-level floors where torments hardly affect your gameplay behavior, including AFKing, exploring, or whatever. Which leads to this critical question. If one big chunk of players, maybe the biggest chunk, is going to avoid torment by running lower levels, and for another chunk, torments don't matter thanks to anima powers, why have torments? Who's the target? Now sure, torments can be designed and iterated to feel more threatening at higher floors when we have plenty of anima powers, but we're already dealing with tougher mobs, dangerous elites, and other effects. The difficulty of Torghast can be tuned through monsters and floor level without needing torments. Blizzard did good to encourage conversation about this Torment subject because, you know, here we are talking about this stuff. But they did themselves a huge disservice by addressing one of the bullet points in defense of Torments, and that's to bank cooldowns and bloodlusts and such. Because that's something that can be designed around, from locking cooldowns while out of combat to allowing only one bloodlust per floor. There have already been plenty of ideas as well as counter ideas, but the problem Blizzard made for themselves is to make it sound like that's the only problem Torments are trying to solve. We can only guess why Blizzard wants, in so few words, to, you know, nudge people along. And most of these guesses around the internet are thinly veiled jabs at Blizzard. It's them being proud and stubborn. They want us to play their way. Yada yada opinion something. I'm no engineer, but I do wonder what sort of strain is going to be put on Blizzard servers in the near future when Shadowlands goes live. Like, what does it take to create, I don't know, what, hundreds, millions of separate, unique Torghast instances per player or group? We can walk into the same freehold, and in Mythic Plus, that changes to the same freehold plus affixes. But what about Torghast? Now, this might mean absolutely squat. Like I said, I don't know any better about this sort of technology, but I'm just throwing the thought out there more out of curiosity. So here's a more educated guess. Why Blizzard wants to eventually get us to climb to that next floor, and that's anima powers. There are certain anima powers out there that, if left alone, encourage a different sort of degenerate gameplay. So it's like bloodlust, but other things. Take Speedy Retreat, for example. When you pick this up, every time you disengage, you gain run speed permanently, and it stacks 30 times for 90% run speed. That's pretty darn good, so what are some players going to do? Some of them are going to play normally. Some of them are going to have their back to the wall and run a macro to hit disengage whenever it's off cooldown. There are also powers that lower the cooldown of disengage, so, you know, you can have efficient buff stacking for the win. Here's one for monks. When you use Touch of Death, it buffs your fortifying brew. This also stacks, and it's permanent. I don't know how high it stacks because that's a lot of waiting, you know, touch of deathing one mob every 3 minutes, until you're satisfied that your fortifying brew increases your health to a ridiculous degree. Most of us aren't going to wait that long, but some will. Those are the only two powers that I identified that I have experience with, and I didn't see any others that behave the same way when I visited Wowhead, so this doesn't seem like a big deal. Either let players play how they want to, or just maybe take these particular powers out and be done with it. But that also stifles design, doesn't it? I mean, there could be more powers that are similar to this coming down the pike. Or maybe it overcomplicates the design, like, okay, maybe these kinds of anima power bonuses should only gain so many stacks per floor. Or maybe instead of using an ability, your run speed just goes up per floor. But then it's only a really good power if you pick it up on a lower floor, so maybe there can be some sort of balance calculation that makes it have a higher chance for this particular anima power to drop on a lower floor. And the rabbit hole just gets really deep, guys, alright? Alright, let's just stop there. Maybe these powers are just bad, and they do encourage degenerate gameplay. But maybe they can stay, and maybe more powers can be made for the other classes if we do something about Torment, or what it is, whatever the heck it is that they stand for, beyond just taking them out because Blizzard can't tell me what to do. Speaking only for myself, this is my mindset. This is my sense of urgency in Torghast. It's not so different from being a kid in a toy store. So you bet that I'm exploring everything, and I'm taking my time to be thorough. I'm not gonna not go to the bathroom, and if the doorbell rings, hey, that's my DoorDash over there, but I'm motivated to keep going, to collect more powers, more phantasma, more broken gameplay, haha! So my sense of urgency just comes from being drunk with anima power. Past the low-level floors, once I'm all anima juiced up, from the experience that I've had over the past couple days, I haven't noticed Torments. And I know from current testing, because, you know, everything is subject to change, yay, that if I'm confronted with a difficult Torment on a high floor, I'm gonna practice that law of least resistance. I'm gonna choose the easier path, which is to select a lower starting floor, where Torments have no bearing, and I can resume my anima party. I'm just gonna push as far as my gear allows and focus on the fun. So to summarize, torments either make me run for the hills, or they don't matter at all because, you know, something something good gameplay. If most players feel this way, then why have them in the first place? It's almost comical that the other day I'm standing by Torments because they're a mechanic that only requires good decision making to almost entirely ignore, but now I'm questioning their nature because it takes too little effort to almost entirely ignore. Torments are an extreme, and this kind of extreme doesn't have a good place in the world of Warcraft. On one side, Blizzard wants players to eventually be nudged along. I mean, like, sure, go ahead and explore, but eventually, you know, we got a line here, move along, please. On the other side of things, players don't want their desires to explore, go away from the keyboard, or to just take their time to feel like they have an upper time limit. Throwing out torments is possible, and it's the easy way out. And it's also tantamount to the end of design. It's tantamount to giving up. I don't know if I agree with this whole degenerate gameplay thing from Blizzard, but it's clearly a concern for them, so I can't just dismiss their concerns either, just like ours shouldn't be. So where's the middle ground? As usual, I have an idea. A bad idea. It's fanfiction, alright? And as usual, it's simple, it's easy enough to implement, and, well, maybe it makes sense. So let's set this up. Players are arguing that they want to explore. They want to also reasonably AFK for non-game, real-life occurrences. Fair enough. Let's give them that opportunity. On a side note, the game client will bump you back to the character select screen after 30 minutes of inactivity in-game, just for a tiny bit of context. But let's also set up the appropriate mood. Where are we? In Shadowlands, where are we in this space? Ah, that's right! We're in Torghast, the Tower of the Damned. Not just a jail, but THE jail! That houses the worst of the worst in what is basically the hell of Warcraft. We're breaking into a jail, and we're not here to blow it up or to liberate all of its prisoners or conquer it, you know, at least not yet. Throughout Torghast, we see guards patrolling, sometimes guards fighting prisoners who are also trying to escape, and it's being run by this cosmic being who's plotting to destroy all of existence. Are our champions, or are we as players, so numb to danger that we just expect to break into this place, murder everyone on our own time, and nobody notices? I think reminding you all where we are is enough to justify that Torghast is a different sort of place. And our exploits do attract attention. That said, we're going to take torments, and we're going to strip almost everything away. So no timers, no mechanics, no debuffs, all that's gone. And we'll just focus on its intention, which is to eventually encourage players to move along. Now, let's build something new around this idea. Something that's, you know, really simple and easy to understand. I call this reinforcements. After so much time on a floor, and this length of time is a totally separate discussion, the empowered guardian of that floor, which is a monster that you have to kill in order to progress to the next floor, is like, huh, where'd my guards go? Seems a little quiet around here, you know? Torghast is simulating an element of awareness. So this empowered mob, in fact, let's rename these mob types from an empowered whatever it is, to a captain, you know, a mob captain. So this captain calls a few guards down to check out what's going on. And throughout the floor, a portal appears at these mob's original location, and they reappear. And that's it. Respawns. Instead of a torment, we'll just add a long enough respawn timer that will cause some of the original mobs on the floor to reappear. Like I said, not all of them. Just some. Maybe one that patrols down a hallway. Or not, if that ends up being like too complicated or frustrating. Maybe an elite that guards an anima power that you happen to already pick up. Maybe some mobs that you can avoid, and some that, crap, you gotta fight through again. But they're no harder than before. They also don't drop phantasma or anima powers. And by the way, if you do kill off that empowered guard, that captain person, which by the way you need to kill anyway, then there is no alert that is sounded, and no guards will appear, no respawns. Makes sense, right? you know, take out the guard captain and suddenly communication is cut off. Unlike Torments, reinforcements are a mechanic that you can kill. But now let's dissect all this, starting with the obvious. It's still a timer, only it's the respawning of, you know, who knows what. Like, hey, mobs respawned right on top of me, Soul, that would super suck. And it would force me or compel me, or it would be an itch in the back of my mind that I need to rush to that captain mob first before it calls mobs in. You know, that's Blizzard telling me how to play their game and freedom, something. But work with me here, okay? We've already moved infinitely far away from the idea that a floor can become impossible or tougher because of stacking debuffs. They're gone. But what about your unmovable principle against timers? I can't get away from that, the same way I can't entirely get away from enrage timers, or respawn timers, reset timers, assault timers, and other things that make WoW have a semblance of life, activity, persistence. But let's reiterate on reinforcements a little bit further based on this very early feedback to make this more exciting, because we're employing a mix of exploration and subterfuge. Let's have certain mobs be pre-flagged, like, hey, these are the mobs that the guard captain is going to replenish by the time it calls down reinforcements. They're identified a little bit differently, like, let's put a badge on top of its nameplate, and then when it's killed, it leaves this easily viewable badge or marker on the ground and on the minimap too. So we can clearly see that will be one of the mobs that's going to respawn at some point while we're exploring. We know it to avoid, and so in the event of a sudden AFK moment, we can very quickly identify that, hey, we're in a good spot or a bad spot, and then make adjustments. At first I thought to myself, you know, maybe detecting these reinforcement mobs should be like an anima power, but I decided against that, because reinforcements are a mechanic that very, very few people should have to deal with, but in case of an emergency AFK, you ought to be informed. I don't know how long it should be until the guard captain calls for reinforcements. Like I said, your AFK timer lasts for 30 minutes. But of course, we want some visual cues of some sort. Like, suddenly an alert pops up on screen, or we hear a yell from the captain that says, hey, fellow guards, report in please. You know, that can happen after a while. Like, after we kill off a number of mobs, and then the captain starts hollering. A certain amount of time later, then guards start coming in and, you know, a couple of his forces are replenished. So there's your timer. Go ahead and start roasting. I'm gonna be nitpicky here too, in case anyone asks. Dead guards will leave their badges behind, right? But only guards whose corpses that have disappeared are gonna be the ones that respond. So we're not gonna have a situation where, stab, stab, you just killed that really badass elite that happened to be marked, and then seconds later it respawns. That's pretty dickish. But as for the actual timing of reinforcements, I think it should be designed in such a way that like 95% of players will never ever see reinforcements. The only ones that will are going to be the ones who are stacking fortifying brew buffs and forgot to kill the main guard for some reason. Or it would be the best players who are pushing well beyond what a normal person is capable of, and they're just going really slow. So yeah, there's a timer. After so many kills, after so much time, with only this much impact. The horror. I mean, maybe it is. I approach this subject with a mission to improve or dismantle Torments because many of them suck. They don't fit right. They don't affect the right audience in the right way. It turns out that, yeah, I ended up stripping Torments down so hard that I ended up making something almost entirely new. Reinforcements bring some roleplay context to what we're doing in Torghast, avoiding trouble. Reinforcements are that reminder that we're in hostile territory. We're dealing with the jailer's guard, not just, you know, our normal fish in a barrel. We're not here to win, we're breaking in, we're stealing a bunch of shit and leaving. Reinforcements play a small part in curbing extreme behavior without affecting most anyone else, not even incrementally every 60 to 120 seconds or 30 to 45 seconds outside of combat. It's kind of ridiculous. So for all my bluster that this whole thing didn't seem like much, it didn't need much, and maybe this video could have been a lot shorter, and maybe by the time you see this, Blizzard is going to have changed their mind and threw this whole notion entirely out. but I think it was critical to get all of my thoughts and analysis out there so that you can understand where I'm coming from as a fan who wants Torghast to be as fun as possible. And of course, doing these sorts of presentation things is a lot of fun for me. It's important to preserve the idea that design is a process of presenting followed by reiterating, and not just immediate rejection. What I'm attempting to do here, at least, is to take these different ideas, wrap a little bit of sensitive lore and story around it, and, well, here it is. Reinforcements, the child of these back-and-forth debates over the past couple of days. Maybe this sucks too, and I'll just try again. Because this is more fun than just, no.